Holy fucking shit, ladies and gentlemen. Withered went fucking hard on this one. God damn, boy! You know, I've never actually paid a lot of attention to Withered until very recently, and the killer is I don't even really have a great excuse or explanation as to why. I just kinda haven't. Which is a shame, because these guys have done a lot. I mean, in the past 20 years, they've put out 4 studio albums, they've toured with everyone from Mastodon to High on Fire to Mayhem, Wu-Tang, Possessed, and many, many more. I actually did see them in 2017 at the Decibel Beer and Metal Fest in Philadelphia. Granted, that event was over 4 years ago, and I was extremely drunk that weekend, so it's likely that I'm perhaps a little fuzzy on the exact details, but I remember that they were playing, I remember hearing them play, and I remember not hating anything that I heard them play. I don't know, do with that information whatever the fuck you will. And yet, despite that, I just don't have a lot of real, genuine experience with Withered, nor have I ever been inspired or motivated to take a real deep dive into their discography. But after having spent a respectable amount of time with the band's upcoming Verloren, their 5th studio album, I now realize I will have to rectify this. I will have to correct this very shortly, because my God, this album is amazing. And my God, if their other 4 albums are even a fraction as good as Verloren, then holy crap, I may have been sleeping on one of the most exciting extreme bands of the 21st century. This is a truly apocalyptic, mind-melting fusion of black metal, death metal, doom metal, with flourishes of noise and folk and sludge and alternative metal sprinkled all the way through, wrapped up in an incredibly grimy yet organic sound mix and production, with incredible performances and incredible songwriting. It's horrifically dense, genuinely unpredictable, and emotionally very bitter and provocative. This is not happy music, to put it bluntly. This is not music you're gonna be jamming at the family fucking barbecue anytime soon. Opening track by Tooth in Tongue starts this album off on an incredibly ominous and oppressive note, initially opening on some very moody and atmospheric guitar work before completely obliterating your skull with some very harsh, vicious, blackened death doom. As thick walls of brutal sludge, thunderous percussion, and venomous, harrowing vocals consume all light and sound in your vicinity, like some disgusting extreme metal black hole. It's genuinely pretty punishing, particularly as the track picks up in momentum on its second half and introduces some very chunky mid-paced grooves that sound like they could have been pulled from the heaviest corners of the minds of Leviathan and Remission-era Mastodon. Then you have tracks like The Predation and Casting in Wait, which initially embrace a very savage, ritualistic kind of black and death metal flavor, akin to that of what I might expect from, like, Belphegor or some 2000s Behemoth, with maybe just a dash of Wu-Tang's mystical fury and energy. But interlaced between the blast beats and the demented wailing vocals, there are also some really brutal, agonizing sludge metal style passages. There are a lot of mid-paced grooves, a lot of really disturbing vocal harmonies and textures and atmospheres. There are parts of The Predation in particular that would not be out of place on a Neurosis or a Today is the Day record. While Casting in Wait once again shows Withered bringing in some more epic arrangements and soundscapes and influences, namely through the very spirited melodic guitar solos and harmonies, and the particularly fantastic climax, which weirdly feels like the bizarre mutant freak child of the riff sludge fest of High on Fire and the extreme psychedelia of Aransi Pazuzu. And guess what, folks? We haven't even gotten to some of the wildest fucking shit on this record. The latter half of this album just completely fucking blew me away. Plain and goddamn simple. See, this is the point where, in my opinion, the record transcends from being sonically brutal to being emotionally and mentally brutal. See, going into Verloren, I was pretty captivated by the promo materials that Season of Mist had sent me, because Mike Thompson talks a lot about the grief, the anxiety, the mental trauma that inspires much of this record, and in turn has inspired much of what Withered has written throughout their duration. With Verloren in particular, there's a level of unease, uncertainty, anxiety, and fear that was created by the COVID-19 pandemic that Thompson has directly brought into the music. And this isn't simply me reading into it and drawing my own conclusion. This is more or less what he says himself. Writing here, when it comes to this album, there was an initial suffering of anxiety because of the uncertainty in the world and the fear of losing this album, because we put a lot into it, are super proud of it, and it is the best Withered album yet. It's important for my inspiration and motivation to go forward. It takes so much effort for us to create a record. The thought of it for it to all be for naught or potentially be wasted just destroys me. The thought of losing Withered, of losing this album, combined with the now somewhat normal anxieties that we have all collectively experienced on some form in the past 15 months, and to some extent, especially if you live in Toronto, are still experiencing, directly fuel a lot of what's happening on this album, namely on the second half, where I think everything is at its most pungent and cathartic. Closing number for Ashen Shores in particular stands out as perhaps one of the most sonically and emotionally devastating cuts on the entire album, with the same explosive nuclear fusion of black death and doom interlaced with some incredibly mournful gothic melodies and vocals and harmonies, almost akin to what I would expect from, like, My Dying Bride or even some type of negative stuff. Even the instrumental passages and interludes carry a lot of emotional baggage and weight. Take, for instance, the incredibly harsh noise and drone music of Passing Through, which was initially created off of recordings that Mike Thompson got at a family funeral. Or even the incredibly rustic and claustrophobic acoustic ballad that is the album's title track, Verloren, which legitimately sounds like the type of stuff I would hear from Panopticon, but if it was swallowed into the world of Silent Hill. In case it wasn't abundantly fucking clear already, allow me to say, I love this album. I don't really have any genuine criticisms or complaints. I could nitpick that the album is really overwhelmingly loud at certain points, and that even after my second and third listen, as much as I was enjoying this record, there were parts where I had to turn down the volume just ever so slightly to prevent myself from developing a fucking migraine. But fuck it, because you know what? A migraine is fucking worth it. What Withered have concocted here, what they have delivered here, is nothing short of incredible, and as such, I'm going to give this a 4.5 out of 5. I don't really know how Withered fans will respond to this album, since, again, I just don't really have enough knowledge to make that call, but I think it's safe to say that if you love super heavy, dark, oppressive, devastating music pulling from all branches of the extreme metal tree, that you're probably gonna have a damn good fucking time with this as well. I would personally feel comfortable right now saying that this is one of the most interesting and exciting extreme metal records I've heard so far in 2021, and yeah, I could potentially see it on my top 10 at the end of the year. However you decide to approach this record, just make sure you actually fucking approach it, because I promise you, you will not be disappointed whatsoever by the absolute clusterfuck that awaits you on this album. 4.5 out of 5, a truly incredible record and experience. Definitely check it out. And that is it for the Metal Meltdown. I'm not an expert, nor do I claim to be. So what do you think? Do you like this record? Do you not like this record? And what do you want to hear from me next? And thank you for watching. Make sure you press subscribe right here so you get updates on the Metal Meltdown-y fucking immediately. And as always, you have yourself a fantastic fucking day.